So currently, the Army's helicopters are pretty old. They're decades old. The Black Hawk, the Apache, the Kiowa, anything you can think of is decades old. And so the Army's looking to replace them. And to do that, they've got a program called Future Vertical Lift. It's going to build an attack helicopter and a reconnaissance helicopter. They're going to go much farther and do much more than current helicopters do. And recently, we visited a company, one company, that's offering a lot of solutions to a lot of problems that Army has. It's Thales. They're in Virginia, and here's what they had to offer. So the first thing up is a digital cockpit. Right now, you still have toggles and switches, all kinds of buttons. When you got to replace things, you got to tear apart the entire helicopter, pretty much, or at least the control panel to make that happen. Pretty much taking smart technology like tablets and making that the cockpit. So they've got anywhere from 2 to 4 touch screens that a pilot can use. They can touch, move, zoom in, just like you do on your iPhone or your iPad or any other kind of tablet or device. They can do all kinds of computer-assisted items with this different kinds of software, from tracking targets, looking at terrain, checking out weather patterns, all kinds of things through these tablets and connected systems.
We're looking at the Thales Flight X cockpit solution, which is an evolution of a long line of Thales cockpits that we've been developing for transport category aircraft as well as military aircraft over many decades. What's different about this than what you currently see in helicopters is an advanced man-machine interface as well as an open systems architecture that allows us to interface with not only Thales software and hardware, but those of third-party systems. So traditionally, a pilot's been required to use a keypad and a textual interface for making changes, but now it's a simple matter of utilizing touch on a display to bring up context-sensitive menuing and to decide what option they'd like to do. So in this case, we're going to remove a waypoint from our flight plan. We can just hit clear. It proposes the new flight plan, and we accept that.
And tying in with that cockpit is a heads-up display. Now, currently, there's a helmet basically that has been in use by the Air Force for about 10 years called the Scorpion, and Thales provides that. And what it does, it gives a monocular viewpoint that connects in with the cockpit and gives a data feed to them and also helps in seeing different types of target acquisition items, navigational headings, and all kinds of data that you need for symbology. Now, Thales is developing a binocular version, so better depth perception with 2 eye holes there, and they've also improved their motion tracker to decrease what's called latency. Basically, if you've ever played with VR and you have a headset on, you move your head quickly, and that tracking doesn't catch up with you, well, it can make you sick, and that can happen to helicopter pilots too. So their advances in decreasing latency has helped in speeding up the processing and allowing for that helmet to work in a real-time way.
So this is the Scorpion helmet-mounted queuing system. So this is a monocular full-color display system with a Hobbit hybrid optical-based inertial tracker. Provides helmet queuing and head tracking for fixed-wing pilots and rotary wing pilots, giving them enhanced situational awareness. What it does is it sits behind the night vision goggle and gives them day-night capability to wear night vision systems while also doing, you know, queuing with symbology in support of their mission. So if that's an A-10 or a gunship, they can look around and have enhanced situational awareness, you know, see symbology, and have that enhanced picture of what's going on below them to support the ground force customer. And then for a helicopter, what it does is provide landing zone symbology and queuing to help them in a degraded visual environment. And then we can also, you know, pull into the optic sensor feeds, et cetera, so have kind of picture-in-picture viewing. So if there's a, you know, lightning pod or sniper pod in the aircraft or some kind of ISR sensor, that can be displayed picture-in-picture with symbology as well to give them a picture of what's going on around them.
Looking ahead of me, I see a silo, kind of a concrete silo where we've dropped a red X. If I go immediately to my right, cue over to my right, I see like a blue diamond shape on a more of a cylinder-type building that I spotted earlier. At the same time, I've got this picture-in-picture video like I'm watching 2 football games at once, but instead of that, I'm watching essentially a drone feed coming into what I'm also seeing with all this other stuff in front of me, a full vision on all sides as I'm looking out of the cockpit. One cool feature about the heads-up display in the helmet is you're going to be able to do what's called see-through technology. So a pilot wearing this helmet and having this technology could essentially look through the floor or through the ceiling of his aircraft and see what's outside through camera systems. So you can really get a fully immersed situational awareness. And that actually also translates to soldiers in the back ready to hit a landing zone. They're going to have their own system, basically a new system that's going to give them a night vision type goggle with new data. They can see out the aircraft before they actually exit the aircraft, so they're not going in blind. For Military Times, this is Todd South.